I'll give you a very simple, very old word. Read.
Hey, you beautiful people. Welcome back to a new video on our channel, Read, Travel, Become. Now, it is a known fact that Dr. Shashi Tharoor, the Congress MP, is a maverick when it comes to use of exquisite words and use of flamboyant vocabulary. His command over the English language and his fancy use of words is something which creates an impact. We all admire him for that. I was really intrigued by what exactly is the process which Dr. Tharoor has been following or is following right now to improve his library of words. In a recent media interaction, Dr. Tharoor himself revealed his secret of what he has been actually doing over the years, because of which he has such a great vocabulary. So in this video, we are going to talk about that process which he used. We are going to talk about that secret which he revealed. I'm going to tell you all about that. So the thing we need to understand here is that the first thing is obviously reading. He has read extensively. Dr. Tharoor has read a lot of books. The first step is obviously reading a lot of books. When you have a great diversity in reading, your vocabulary automatically improves. But what should we actually do while reading? What is the process that Dr. Tharoor followed while reading these books? That I'm going to tell you in this video. But before I discuss that process, I will also tell you about three books which Dr. Tharoor recommends extensively. He has quoted these books more than once and he wants all of us to read these books. First, to fall in love with the habit of reading, to develop a reading habit, and also these books will help us to improve our own vocabulary. So this is going to be a fun, short, informational video. Make sure you watch the video till the end. You may never know which thought or fact may resonate with you and change the course of your life. So let's get started.
I lived in an India without television, without computers, without Nintendo, without PlayStation, without mobile phones. And I was an asthmatic child, so I was very often confined to bed, unable to breathe. All I had were books. Books were my escape, books were my education. And because I read, and I read above my age level, and I read anything I could get my hands on, I developed the kind of mind that God has now blessed me with.
The first book which Dr. Tharoor wants every one of us to read is the Mahabharata. Is a book which actually everybody recommends, but very few people actually read it line by line. Dr. Tharoor has compared the Mahabharata to be a library of its own, a library of wisdom, a library of ideas, narratives, everything. So there are a lot of editions of Mahabharata. You can find a lot of editions, you can find a lot of different authors, but Dr. Tharoor has recommended P. Lal's Transcreations, and this is the book which impacted him the most, and this is the book which he thinks all of us should definitely read. There is a certain narrative which this particular book follows in the form of essays, in the form of different storylines, which really intrigued Dr. Tharoor to recommend it to everyone. This book was also cited as the main inspiration behind Shashi Tharoor's own book, The Great Indian Novel. The second book which Dr. Tharoor recommended was The 100-Year-Old Man Who Climbed Out of the Window and Disappeared by the Swedish writer named Jonas Johansson. Now, Dr. Tharoor is a fan of humorous novels, of satirical novels. He has quoted in one of his interviews that he has read almost all books of P.G. Wodehouse which are written in a similar way, which are written in a humorous way. So this particular book by the Swedish writer is actually a humorous take on the events in history. It has a comical angle towards all the events which happened in the history, and it's an ironical book, it's a satirical book, you can say. He says when you pick up this kind of a genre, basically which is amusing and which is comical in nature, you get engaged with the book more proactively and you tend to complete the book more easily. So this is the second book which he recommends. And the third book which Dr. Tharoor recommends extensively is Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru's book, The Discovery of India. Dr. Tharoor had said that this book actually gave him the clear, precise image of a developing India in the last 70 years. This book has been like a handbook for him to study various political, religious, cultural, societal, the different areas in which India was developing. All of this is discussed in this book, The Discovery of India. The timeline of the book is very different and it's a complex read. It takes some time to read and it's very heavy on politics. It's a politically influenced book. But Dr. Tharoor has recommended that everybody should read this book and try to understand the cultures of India, try to understand the backstory of what India was like, which makes it a very compelling read for both readers and non-readers. Okay, so now you are a reader. You read books, you read extensively. But do you always remember those fancy words which you had encountered? When I talk about my case, I tend to forget those fancy words and I'm not able to, you know, remember. So there's one trick which Dr. Tharoor had discussed in one of his media interviews, which is as follows. So whenever you are reading a book, you encounter some word which you don't know the meaning of. So the first step is, you don't need to go find the meaning of the word in the dictionary. You don't need to do that. The first thing you need to do is try to understand in what context the word is fitted there. Try to understand what the meaning of the word would be. Keep that meaning in your mind, and when you encounter that word again, maybe in an editorial or a book or any kind of a news article or anything, try to fit that understanding of that word into the new context, and after that get to the actual meaning of the word. What happens from this is, when you understand that what gaps you had in understanding the context, in understanding the actual meaning of the word, this gap is filled and you tend to not forget this word. This word is imprinted on your brain. And the next step which Dr. Tharoor did was, whenever he found such fancy word, he tried to use it in his conversation. Like, if you learn a new word, try to use it in the conversation, maybe on social media, or maybe when you're talking to someone, when you're talking to your family members, your friends, anyone. So that way, he has built an extensive library of words of his own. If you follow Shashi Tharoor on social media, he can be seen using a variety of words in his tweets, which are definitely some newfound words, which are definitely words which he has encountered himself while he was reading some books. So that way, Shashi Tharoor has described that he actually never picks up dictionaries. He rarely picks up dictionaries and, you know, tries to learn words. What happens that way is, we tend to forget things. You can never learn something by, you know, memorizing it. So this is the thing that he has been following, and I was really, really intrigued by this topic, and I'm going to follow this thing. I'm going to mark all the fancy words, and you may see me using fancy words in my next videos. There are a lot of interesting videos lined up, so stay tuned to the channel. And yeah, that's all for this video. I really hope you like this short video. If you like my content, do hit the like button, comment down below what your thoughts are, and subscribe to my channel, and also press the bell icon so that whenever I put a new video, a notification pops up in your feed. And thank you so much for all the support. See you in the next video. Bye bye.